Years ago, I had an experience of light. My whole body was filled with light. I felt connected by that light to the universe. I became conscious of an exquisite radiance permeating the fabric of all life. I saw that every living thing has its own special luminous quality. I wanted to explore the secret of that magical feeling. I felt a yearning to understand it. I realized from my experience that the source of that light is reborn in every moment of creation. Everyday light is just the visible aspect of that infinite light, which isn't out there someplace. But right here, we begin this journey with the familiar world, the world around us. We live in a world of light and shadow. Faces. The earth is filled with light. Fire, a primal force, a universal symbol of energy. Holy light appears in every religion, in every Jewish synagogue. A light burns day and night. The Sabbath is celebrated with candlelight. Hanukkah, the Hebrew festival of lights. the Buddha radiated light, according to his disciples. They say the rays of knowledge rose like light above his head and around him. The light of Christ begins with the Annunciation. Those whose lives were touched by his shared his radiance. In his healing ministry, Christ was said to channel light. According to the New Testament, his face did shine as the sun. In every faith, the teacher embodies inner light. The faces of some Indian teachers communicate this glowing presence. Ancient Indian scriptures say that we could become as gods with the visible light of heaven manifest in us. Since the beginning of time, people have tried to fathom the mysteries of celestial light. At Stonehenge, the sun, the stars, and planets were observed, revealing the progressions of heavenly bodies. The sun was worshipped for centuries in Egypt, revered as a compassionate force, communicating directly with humans, each ray extending a hand to accept offerings and give life. Sphere of light, a mandala, a sun-like form, a symbol of wholeness, a way of experiencing different levels of reality. Like the sun radiating from a center, its design ignites inner light. Thank you. A place of worship is designed to use light to heighten the senses and invite the spirit. The body itself is a temple of light. There's a sea of electricity in the human body. Holy light is not just a metaphor, but an actual energy. Can we know the electrical patterns of our inner worlds? High energy photography records the electrical discharge as a current is passed through living things. Our lives are connected to the energy of all life. We are radiant beings. Not only the radiance, but the rhythms of the universe touch our lives. Time brings changes. A message of new birth, others complete their cycles, and life is embraced by the darkness of death. Ancient texts speak of light in the afterlife. From the Book of the Dead, do not forget this secret. When your mind and body separate, you can see the primary clear light. It's like a mirage, subtle but bright. Do not be afraid. It is the same light you also radiate. Is there light after death? Reports come from people who have returned to life after being pronounced dead, going down a tunnel with a light at the end. At first, the light is dim, growing gradually brighter. A feeling of great love and the infinite. there's a great desire within me to know how the world works. To understand the intention of physical matter. Yes, and yes, and yes again cries out my heart. Today I touch the earth, willing and loving is she that touches me in return. O great mother, guide me. Show me that pressing, lifting, blinding light of love, born in eternity and living in all that is. All that is, walk with me now. Clear my mind. Clear my eyes. Clear this, my body, that I might receive you fully. Let me become a giver of light.